Lonnie has congenital generalized lipodystrophy. Her specific mutation is AGPAC2. Basically, what she has is an absence of body fat. Her body does not process or store fat, and therefore any fat that she takes in, it attaches itself to her organs and ultimately gives her fatty liver, fatty pancreas, and it goes to the heart. It doesn't store under the skin. When Alani was born, she was lean. She was really small, but she looked like a bodybuilder. She had a lot of muscles, and she was really stiff. So I told her doctor, something's wrong with her. And he goes, what do you want to do? And I was like, I want to go to the hospital. We went in. The doctor said, hey, it was an emergency room doc. He's like, what are you here for? And I was like, something's wrong with my baby. She doesn't look right to me. She doesn't look like my other kids. And there was one genetic specialist, I remember, he asked me, what did I think she had? And I kept Googling the whole time. I was Googling muscular babies and what do you do if your baby has muscles? And the only thing I found was the word lipodystrophy. Of course, I didn't know the specific mutation, so when he asked me, I said, I think she has lipodystrophy, and he goes, you're right. From there, they set us up on all these tests and genetics to confirm, and from there, it was just a roller coaster, a nightmare. It really was. I when they told me that's what they thought she had, I just cried and cried. I read a little bit about it. I didn't know enough, but I knew that she was sick, and I knew there wasn't a cure. I plugged in the word lipodystrophy, and any professor or doctor or anybody that ever said the word, I sent them an email and a picture of Alani, and I said, please help us. My baby, this is her, and I don't know what to think. Elaine Cochran with NIH was one of the respondents, and she said to me, find some others just like you, and then get back with me. And she told me about the study here at NIH, and that, you know, the specifics of the clinical trial, that we could go on a clinical trial for the medication, and the medication would be myoleptin that would essentially assist Alani with the insatiable appetite. She has responded very well. Her appetite has decreased. It's a compromising lifestyle. This disease came and it changed everything. I no longer can work. She can't be in daycare. Her immune system's compromised. So we're very limited to where we can go. She has heat and cold intolerances. So being outside and things normally, like you would take a kid to the park, she can't do those things. You know, one minute you're on top of the world, the next minute it's on top of you. But there's people out there. They care.